In this tutorial, I am going to walk you through creating your first automated test script using TestComplete. The first thing that we need to do is create our project. And a project is just a collection of all of your test cases and relevant artifacts. So I'll click the Create New Project button, and now I get to give my project a name, and we'll call it My Web Project. And then select Next. And here I get to choose the type of application I would like to work with. As you can see, TestComplete can create test cases for Windows desktop applications and web and mobile applications as well. For today, we're going to focus on functional testing of web pages. And then I get into the visualizer options. And the visualizer is a feature of TestComplete that allows us to capture screenshots of every test step while we're recording. So I'll leave these default settings on, select Next, and then I get to the last step of setting up our project, which is choosing the scripting language. Now, I'm not going to be showing you anything that requires scripting today. However, if you are interested in scripting your tests, you can just choose the scripting language that you're most comfortable with. And for me, that happens to be JScript. And now that I've selected that, my test set is ready to begin. And all I need to do to record my new test is click the Record New Test button. And you can see that TestComplete is going to minimize down and leave me with my recording widget, showing us that all of my actions are being recorded. So at this point, all I need to do is navigate through my test case the same way I would with a manual test. Now we're going to be doing a web application test today, so I will open up Firefox and navigate out to where my login screen is. And now I just need to log in with my user credentials, so I'll use my username of demo user and the password of pass123, and then click the login button. And now that I'm logged in, what I would like to do is verify my user's cash balance. Now to do that, we can add a checkpoint. Checkpoints are how TestComplete makes sure that our application is behaving properly. And I can come up to my recording window, expand my checkpoint dropdown, and now you can see I have several different types of checkpoints to choose from. I could create a checkpoint to verify the contents of a database, or make sure that an image has loaded accurately, or even that a table has all of the correct data in it. But what I'll do for today is create a property checkpoint, which is the most commonly used. It allows us to verify any individual aspect of our application. And if I'm ever unsure of which checkpoint to use, we do have a checkpoint wizard, which will guide you to the correct checkpoint based on what you need. So I'll select my property checkpoint, and all I need to do for this is drag my bullseye around the application, and you can see that we're highlighting all of the controls with a red rectangle, so there's never any confusion about which control we're working with. So I'll hover over this 84,000 cash balance, release the mouse button, and then TestComplete's going to gather up all of the information on this control for me. Now all I need to do is click Next, and I can see the properties associated with that text label, and I just want to look at the text property, ensuring that my user has the 84,000 balance. So I'll finish out my checkpoint, and now I just need to log out and close down Firefox. So I'm going to click the logout button, close out my browser, and then stop recording. And as you can see, I now have all of those actions that I just performed in our keyword test mode. Now after I've recorded my test, I can easily go through and edit the test steps if I accidentally recorded something or misclicked. And you can see here that I have a test step where I was tabbing in between my username and password field. This isn't part of my test case, so I can right-click on that and select Delete. I can also see that here I accidentally clicked on my web page. This is also not part of the test, it's just a potential failure point. So I can remove these steps as well. Makes our test cases that much more robust. So now as you can see, I've got a cleaned up test, and I can run my test here, and TestComplete's going to go back through and play back all of the actions that I just recorded. So I'll click that Run Test button now, and we can see that Firefox has kicked off, and I'm logging into my application, verifying the balance, and then logging out. And now that that's done, we can see the step-by-step actions that TestComplete took to execute the test in our keyword test log. The very first step being launching Firefox. And if I look in the information pane at the bottom, I can see the version of Firefox that we used, as well as the URL that we navigated to. And then, as I begin navigating through the test steps, you can see our visualizer screenshots. Now, the screenshot on the left was taken at the time of test creation, and the screenshot on the right was taken just now when I played back the test. So I can always compare my runtime images versus the expected baseline. And as you'll see, while I progress through the test step, TestComplete is updating those screenshots and highlighting each control with a red rectangle. So as I'm trying to replicate my test following through the log, I know every step along the way what I should be performing. Now if I ever want to see the corresponding test step, I can double-click on this log item, and that will highlight the corresponding test step in the test case. So that was recording a keyword test. Now, if you are interested in scripting your tests, you don't have to script them manually from scratch. You can record your tests directly to script. So if I come up to my recording window here, I can expand that and you can see we have the record script option. Now, all of the actions and functionality will be exactly the same as I just showed you. However, instead of creating a keyword test, we will record everything into the scripting language that you've selected. So that is recording your first test case in TestComplete. Thank you for viewing the video.